Hi, welcome back. I'm John, and Becky is coming around the corner, and we are the Sorcerers. And we have a Red Up Box. This is our second one. I don't know if we covered it in our last video, but the first box we got was horrendous. We think that it had to be some sort of mistake, because number one, it didn't come with a receipt or a manifest, so it didn't say what the items were. And if you look at our last video, which, sorry, was quite a while ago, but the items were off. They are stuff that you wouldn't even give a second look at. So we donated 90% of them. I think we listed three items. We did sell one thing. It was a Vineyard Vines men's vest. It was wash worn, but it had a nice fade to it, so you know, some people like that worn look. But everything else was awful. There was a jacket that we thought was redeemable, but the size and the fabric tags were cut out of it. And from my understanding, that through ThredUp, you're not supposed to submit those to them, and they're not supposed to sell them. So we don't know what they were doing. We don't know who was working that day or what kind of day they were having, but we got an awful box. They were pilled up, covered in hairs, stained. They were just awful. So that said, we contacted ThredUp, tried to be positive people, but we let them know that we were extremely disappointed. And I was looking at their website, looking at the page and how they describe what a rescue box is. And in the page where they advertise it and promote it, it states that, I'm paraphrasing, that the item's great condition, may need washing or dry cleaning. And then when you get your receipt, when you've committed and made the purchase, at the bottom of your electronic receipt, it said ThredUp Box Rescues may contain items that are significant cosmetic flaws, may need sewing, repairing, things along that line. So it completely conflicts with the way they advertise and I'll say really win to get you to buy it. And then once you're committed, where they say there's no refunds, no returns, then they say, oh, that's not exactly what you're going to get. So I know a lot of people that are in the business that we do buy rescue boxes, and they do videos of opening them, and some show their disappointment, some get some great ones. When we sit back there since we got that last box, and we've watched some videos, and these people are getting items that you get off the runway, for crying out loud. So we're thinking, well, maybe this is just a mistake in the first box. Again, when we contacted them, we told them we wanted to cancel this second one. They told us that they would and that they had in their communication. So I was consistently following up, waiting for our 3 to 5 day refund, which never happened. And that time expired, I contacted them and said, what's the status? And they said, whoops, we've already sent it to you. So with us sending it to you, we can either give you a 20% discount on this one, or we can give you a return label. We opted to take the 20% and roll the dice and give it a one last shot and see if they'll redeem themselves with this box. And that'll dictate whether we continue to do future business with them. So here we are. And
so the first box was from Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania. This one's from Arizona.
Yes.
And Arizona, so usually they're better.
Supposedly. Becky knows more about where the buildings are supposed to come from. Oh, this is another rescue box. It's 25 items for $60. Clothing in it. Variety. Women's clothing? And women's clothing only.
Yeah.
Well, the other one was variety.
No, it was
25
mixed.
Oh, well, but we got a men's vest. Well, they didn't return it, so. Oh, this one has the receipt, so that's encouraging.
So this says,
nicely folded. That's encouraging. Nice color setup. Looks like we're going to get all grays, whites, and blacks. All right. Oh, I see a tag already. Well, all right.
Reasonable. A racer back tank. It's a nice one. Nice condition. So it's got a mesh backing. Looks good. What did these get? Maybe $15 on a good day? Okay. Black's not bad.
All right. All day blacks. Oh, these are skinny jeans. These are men's. 28-28.
Ah, super. With pads. So that's a good one. Old Navy always does well. Nice black men's super skinny. Covered in hair though, I will say. I don't know if it's hair or lint, but it looks like hair to me. Consistent as long as you have a nice product. These are really nice. Speedy. Yeah, see, it sucks. Cut out. So we'll just have to measure it and best estimate. I thought it weren't supposed to do items of tags.
That's what
I call
this.
Oh, okay.
This is the hand tailor
loft.
Gray.
Any good fabric? Extra large gray cardigan. I see what might be deodorant. Tags cut out. It's cotton rayon wool. It looks like it's in good condition. Just has some. One of the tag, oh, it's probably the store tag. These are no tags. Other than that, it's not filled up or anything. So, I would give this maybe a B. If I was giving grades.
Jones, New York. It's a little tee kind of thing. It's like a casual knit top.
It's nautical style, but it has anchor buttons on the shoulders, which a lot of people tend to like, but it's not in the best condition, that's for sure.
So we do not waste our time listing stuff that
are worn.
I mean, we like stuff with tags. These are cute. These are Stevie.
Awesome.
Those are size.
Must come from the same person.
But we'll just measure
them. Yep. Another pair, Old Navy, Stevie, hunting knit, houndstooth, zipper pockets. Doesn't look like there's any real wear to them, so that's good. That's redeemable.
That's good.
cheap fabric. Just, I give that a yeesh. Yeesh.
Alright, this is a blazer by Mason Jewels. Wool, polyester, cotton, rayon. It's just a blazer. I don't know if it's a good brand. I've heard of it, but I don't know. I'm looking.
Yeah, it looks nice. That has anchor button as well. One button blazer. Feels like a quality piece, but we'll have to look that up because I'm not familiar with it either.
So this stuff, what would you have picked up from the bin? Because this is about, what, $2.40 a piece.
At the bin? Oh, here. I would have picked up the Old Navy men's pants, and that is, I've only gotten the Jewel, I mean the, what are these women's ones called? Stevie's? I've only gotten those, so the three Old Navies so far. And the two women's Stevie's would have been iffy, depending on how full our cart was.
Jones wear, like a cocktail dress, it's like satin, size 16, it's cute, surplus.
Thank you.
What's that?
Short dress.
Yeah.
It's in great condition, so it has that going for it.
Here's an Adidas sports bra. Scarlett can wear this.
Yeah.
That's cute.
So that's just something we'll give to our daughter. It's in good condition, but Adidas doesn't do very well.
These are like workout pants, but there's no brand on them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Let's see if I can find one. They've got interesting lower part of the leg. It's a mesh, which is kind of cool. It doesn't feel cheap,
well, these
though.
These are vintage, but not cute.
Yeah, tags cut out.
Yeah, it's hard to resell items that the tag has been cut out.
Yes.
The fabric tag has been cut out, the brand tag has been cut out. These are vintage high-waisted trouser pants.
Interesting.
No tag.
Handmade.
But, yeah, they're probably, yeah.
These are handmade. Not,
so we
sell not
some
poorly done, so. There better be a diamond ring at the bottom of
this
box. This
is a Nuitag like foiled wool moto jacket from Ann Taylor.
Okay, that's got a change.
But it's got like stain on the inside of it. But that's pretty. It's Nuitag's.
That's
so it's a like a foiled wool moto jacket, medium petite. Retail is $179.
That has a chance.
Yeah. That's something we would get given.
Yeah. We'd be like, ooh, that's a good one. Throw it in there. So this is nice. Yes.
So that will redeem the box.
Yes. Because
right?
We'll probably sell this for $30, $40.
Small petite.
Mm-hmm. We'll try to get
that's
our daughter to wear that one.
That's
a good one.
Yeah, dark gray.
Yeah. Was it rayon?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, that's a nice one. And that is in great condition. first thing we go to is check the pit and the crotch. And the pits are damaged.
Yeah.
So this
we
is
don't
a no
sell
go.
Anything that we would not feel comfortable saying this is nice. So this is brand Shein. It's one of those Chinese brands. It's like $2 with free shipping. She doesn't like clothes yet, but we're hoping soon she will, and we'll have tons of stuff for her.
Lululemon.
Oh, good.
Yay.
These are the good ones. So Lululemon leggings.
And look like excellent condition.
They're that gray metallic silver.
Awesome.
Nice.
Oh, that's a good one.
Let's see if we can find the size. So that's a good one. Makes some
noise. It's always fun trying to find a size and move them.
These are size 6.
Nice.
Nice.
That's
Yay.
Your size. And I'll try to fit into those Old Navy pants and we'll all have something to wear.
What's this?
Ooh, that's cool.
Peach Love California. Oh, this is a poncho jacket. This is adorable.
Oh, that is nice.
See, some things are...
We would definitely
wear
that.
Wear an old brand, but if they're cute,
yeah.
It doesn't matter the brand. Mm-hmm. That's adorable. I like that. And...
By the way, if anybody out there watches our videos, even if you haven't subscribed yet, and you see an item that you like as we go through this, let us know. We will work with you.
This is pretty, too. This is almost famous.
We'll give you a watcher's discount. Sorry, go ahead.
Midi dress.
By who?
Almost famous.
Mm.
Yeah, it's pretty.
It's nice, but that's not...
I mean, it's a junior's dress.
Yeah, it is nice. Yep. That might get maybe 15. Maybe? Because of the brand? 20?
25.
Okay.
Alright, this is another brand. From China. This is called, oh look, it's got this star. Well, hopefully that's not one of those.
Exploding ones?
That's pretty though. Look at this dress.
That is nice.
It's really pretty.
Ooh, I like that.
So it's emerald green satin.
And
high
waist. Yeah, that is a nice dress. I don't knock those on. Chinese brands that aren't well known or not popular, because I found some at the bin that are not sold in retail stores around here, and they do well. They actually have good sale rates, so that's a nice one. Just have to figure out, I think it's called Mar 16, M-A-R 16. And the tag says, made dress plants of the genus Buttercup.
I have no idea what this is. I think it's a skirt.
Mm-hmm.
It looks handmade.
Oh, that's kind of neat, though.
It's got like a ruffle in the back.
I like that. It's like
it
kind
might
of flat.
It might be vintage. It's got metal.
Yes. Metal zipper.
Isn't
that weird? That is nice. I would sell that. I would grab that at the bin even without a tag or label. Just because the back fat is classic. Isn't it? I forget what they call that.
Drink.
I bet this is from the 60s or 70s.
This is... It's the blank tag, but I think that might be. Let's see if we can find something here. No.
Amendments?
No, cleanings. It's cleanings. And these do well. This is a Champion bronze. It's like a double layer tank. It's got the sports bra built in. Strappy.
They do well, but not for a lot.
Yeah. Well, they're expensive than the Target.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
It's on C9 or whatever it's called.
I don't know what size it is, though. That's cute. I like it. And then this is...
I can't put that together. I struggle with that. Two pieces.
This brand is called ACHRO Acro. Ooh, it's Gauchos.
Whoa, look at the size of those. Oh my goodness.
Yeah,
I think it's a good brand.
It's all peeled up. You can see the waistband's all peeled up. But we'll have to look them up.
Yeah, it might be salvageable. If it's a good brand, but those are wide leg gauchos.
Yeah, I would not get those from the
No, I don't either. I would look them up before I tossed them back though.
So this box is definitely better than the last one.
Yes, it
so
is.
So we're looking for at least 10 items to list at least $25. So that would be.
One.
This. No, 10 items at least $25.
Oh. Okay.
Lululemon.
I would say this one.
This one.
Two.
This will count for two.
Okay, so that's
three,
four.
Old Navy jeans, five.
Then two women's Old Navy. Would you do those? Combined.
Mm-hmm. If they look like they're the same, you could come together.
Okay, so we'll make that six.
Six. Oh, there's stuff over here.
Yeah. This possibly, they might be handmade vintage. This actually is vintage.
Seven. Eight. Nine.
I'm going to say this one. I think it could do it. Possibly. No. All right.
How about, an Adidas tape, we're going to give that for $1. This dress might do like $20, $25. So that's nine. We just need one more thing. I like this dress.
Okie dokie.
How about the...
Well, that'll get you 12. I might have to look that particular Adidas up. I mean, everybody... Need sports bras, so
yeah.
It looks like it's practically new. I don't really see any wear on it.
So maybe this and this
combined
25.
Yeah.
The outside is in good condition.
Okay, everything looks
so better than the last box. At least we got some new attack stuff. We'll make our money back.
Well. Make our money back and probably, just off the top of my head, profit 200. Potentially. 200, list 10 things. That's not too bad. Probably in our range with the stuff we get at the bins, but if we spend $60 at the bins, we would probably profit $700-$800 on that. But bins aren't open, so we're forced to look at other resources.
This says Suit Plus Fabric Content Unknown. They won't even tell you, a care label that actually cares. 80% of the nasty stuff about fashion happens after you take your garment home. Greenhouse gases, gross, wasted water, sad. Don't be gross and sad.
actually clean. 85% of dry cleaners use a creepy toxic chemical called PERC that is linked to respiratory issues, birth defects, and air pollution. Yucks. Skip the standard dry cleaning and opt for green and organic dry cleaners if you can. Wow. Wasn't expecting that.
That'll be how it fit on the title of the item, that's for sure. That will exceed the characters. I'll put that in the description.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I don't know. Do we give them another chance? Would you buy another box anytime soon?
Probably.
I
just
would think about
fun.
It. Yeah,
well,
these are like a fun one. I don't want to say we have a lot of disposable income, but we would do it on a, hey, you want to get a FedEx box kind of deal. We wouldn't rely on it. But, oh, I lost my train of thought.
So count this up.
I don't know if we have time for all that.
25, 22, 50, 25, 4, 207, 20.
That will be all right.
Okay. We're out.
Yep. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And stay tuned for further adventures. Like, share, subscribe.